Pharyngeal Reflex Testing During Brain Death Examination by Dr. David K. Urion.
The last part of the examination would be to examine the lower brainstem by looking for any kind of oropharyngeal response. We might do this by suctioning the patient or alternatively taking a tongue blade or a cotton swab like this and inserting it deep into the back of the throat. We'd be looking here for any kind of palatal elevation or response in any of the musculature in the retropharyngeal area, and we see that there's none.
Pharyngeal reflex. With a normal and intact pharyngeal reflex, when you insert a tongue blade deep into the back of the patient's throat, you will see that the palate will elevate. In patients with an abnormal pharyngeal reflex, when you insert a tongue blade deep into the back of the patient's throat, you will see no response by the musculature in the retropharyngeal area. Clinical pearl. Alternative pharyngeal reflex. Another way to investigate the pharyngeal reflex is to perform stimulation of the carina. Some providers feel that patients who have been intubated for a long period of time may have a pharynx that becomes habituated to stimulation because of the continuous presence of the endotracheal tube. Stimulation of the carina can be accomplished by suctioning the endotracheal tube and looking for the patient to cough. In patients with normal pharyngeal reflex, you will observe that the patient coughs in response to stimulation of the carina. In patients with an abnormal pharyngeal reflex, you will observe an absence of coughing in response to such stimulation.